Yo, what's up? This is your boy, Celebrity Blue, Fatty Magazine here on Sunset Boulevard at the Gallery Sparta. This is a red carpet event for Richo Grieco for his historic paintings, one-of-a-kind paintings.
So if you had a choice to choose, acting or painting?
Acting, definitely. Painting is hard for me, I think, in the sense that coming up with my own style or being really, you know, within myself like some true great artists are.
Have you had a chance to work with Richo Grieco as an actress and actor?
No, not yet, but I mean, I would definitely love that.
Definitely, so you're looking forward to going inside and meeting him?
I am, extremely. Definitely. Hi, I'm Deanna Lee Douglas, and I'm here with Fat Ink Magazine.
What's the word on the streets? What's the singing career and what's going on?
Yeah? Oh, gosh. I don't know. I'm pretty low profile. But I still do a lot of recording. I just finished a new Christmas album with a lot of my buddies, Vince Gill and his wife.
The artists that you're working with, are producing, anybody right now?
Any famous people?
Yeah. Definitely. Give names if you can.
Yeah, well, they're all very famous in my mind.
Are you an artist yourself?
No, I'm an artist in terms of entertainment and such, but I've been a huge fan of art ever since I was a kid. My favorites are Salvador Dali and Tamara Dilipica.
So do you feel a lot of these artwork inspires you as an actress? Like just, you know, motivation just by looking at your paintings?
Sure. I mean, I think art stirs the soul, and I think all art comes from that deep, creative, instinctual, soulful place. So absolutely.
So have you ever had a chance to work with Richard as an actor?
No, I have not. I've not been so lucky.
Not yet.
Hey, I'm Kim Poirier, and this is Fat Ink.
So have you ever had a chance to work with Richard?
I have not had a chance to work with Richard.
Not yet, right?
Not yet, but I'm hopefully in time. I'm looking to be, that'll be awesome.
You're looking out fly, so can you tell us?
Thank you, man. I'm like, I'm a little, you know, summertime attire real quick, you know?
A little artsy, right? It's artsy,
yes, exactly.
Man.
I mean, I feel like I was, you know, artsy. I was like, I feel like I might be one of the paintings today.
Oh, but you might, right? Might have you a little platform ready for you.
You know, exactly. I can be art or something. You know.
So tell us a little bit more, why you like so much about the paintings?
You know what, I've always appreciated art, man, in every form. I mean, whether it's acting or dancing or paintings or drawings. I mean, from animation to comic books, everything. I just appreciate the art form. So anything that somebody can do that I can't do impresses me.
So does that come and play into with your acting?
Yeah, well, not completely. I mean, it's not like I take my acting. I mean, acting I see in colors because of characters. But, I mean, that's more of a metaphor than it is, you know, actuality. Yo, this is Walter Jones. Just want to say what's up to Fat Ink Magazine. Y'all be cool, man.
What brings you to the start of the fight?
You know, I mean, it just seemed like an awesome event. You know, why wouldn't I be here?
So, you know, the art. So, have you ever met Richard?
No, I haven't. Hopefully I can tonight, yeah.
So what are you planning, because now I know you're a singer, and yeah. Are you planning to maybe cross the road with maybe acting as well?
Yeah, you know, that's down the road, that's the plan. Right now I'm recording my first album. I just played at the El Rey last night.
Any motivational like words for all the, you know, maybe your fans or followers?
Yeah, just that, you know, I mean, you know, I started off, you know, just in the bedroom and, you know, playing guitar, and, you know, turned out now it's for millions. So, you know, just keep following your dreams.
Can we maybe get a little vocal for the fans?
No. I gotta rest it. I'm in the studio. I can't waste it. What's up, Fat Ink Magazine? This is Mackenzie Borg.
Have you worked with Richard yet?
I never have, no.
Not yet.
I'm hoping.
Soon.
One of these days.
Right next day.
I know. It's great.
So how's the life on Sons of Anarchy? I know you.
Well, you know, that episode just aired today. Like, they replayed my episode for some reason. Well, I guess they're, you know, getting everybody pumped up for the new season coming in. So, yeah. That's like my favorite show. Like, not only that I worked on it, but like to you know, to watch it. This is Bruno Amato, and you're watching Fat Ink.
Yes, of course. And when I was a little kid, actually, it was my dream to become an artist. So my mom told me, like, oh, this is not profession, because I was born in a little city in Ukraine, in west of Ukraine, and it wasn't cool to be a painter or singer. But I did really well. My grandfather, he was a great artist.
How's Randy Jackson working with Randy?
He is so, like, he's an amazing person. Actually, I saw him yesterday, and we had a business meeting. And one more time, time, I realized that he is not just a like a good and professional. He really an amazing person inside, just, and he's just, I don't know. I really am blessed to have a chance to work with him. Hi, I'm Mika Newton, and you're watching Fennec.
Well, definitely, we got Katrina Norman that's right on the red carpet, looking all gorgeous. What's your latest show?
Our show Hit the Floor just got picked up for a second season.
Yeah. Congratulations.
Thank you. Just got back from Canada, wrapping up a film called Strings.
So, what made you get into acting? Is there, like, has always been a passion of yours?
You know, actually it hasn't. I was deathly afraid of public speaking when I was younger. I started out here in the business as a dancer. So, as a dancer, you're already an actor, you just don't verbalize.
Well, you're on stage.
Yeah, exactly.
And
so,
confidence.
I figured, you know, face my fears and challenge myself.
Well, I guess it's taking off.
Yeah, definitely I'm having success. Shout out to Fat Ink.
I feel like I might have talked to you before, but Maury?
Mario.
Where are you from?
I'm from California.
Oh, you have like an accent.
What kind of accent?
I don't know, Mario. I don't know the way you said it. Anyway, how are you?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm good. It's such a pretty day out. Usually when we do these carpets, it's like either dark or I'm usually really cold. So
it's a nice day.
It is.
Especially to watch paintings, correct?
I know. I'm excited to go in there because I feel like this is something I actually don't do often. I did it earlier in the year for the first time, and I've always wanted to do it, so I'm like so excited.
Where have you been, like, enthusiastic? As an artist?
I love art. I mean, I feel like as a performer, and I just like art and talent in general. So anything that involves that kind of thing, I'm like so into. And I just like to see, sometimes they don't tell you, but I just, if there's like a title to something or a description, just there's so many things that like other people see for, you know, something specific. So I'm so intrigued by that.
What's the latest buzz on the streets with, you know, maybe the latest projects?
Oh my gosh. Well, we just got picked up for season 2 of Hit the Floor. I saw you guys talking to Katrina Norman. Thank you. We're so excited about that. So apparently the writers are in the writing room making magic. And I'm in the ABC Family Lounge. I'm also doing a show called ABC Families on the Set. So I'm going to different sets for movies or some of their TV shows, and I am hosting American Latino. Hey, what's up? This is Valerie Ortiz on the red carpet, and I want to say what's up to Fatty Meg.
So, have you ever met Richard Grieco?
No, I have not.
So it's gonna be the first time.
I am. I'm very excited.
So you're an actress, correct?
Yes, I am.
Probably looking forward to maybe working with you in the future.
Yes, of course. What? Yeah.
Why not? Right?
Yeah. Why not?
Are you a fan of art?
Yes.
So
I'm a fan of art, but I don't know enough about it.
So maybe teach you some tricks.
Yeah. That's why I'm here. I'm here to learn a little. Magazine. Hi, I'm Tamara Duarte, and this is Fat Ink Magazine.
So what brings you to this event?
Well, I'm going to support my good buddy Richard. We worked on a couple of films together. We were in Almighty Thor together. And recently, I produced a film called A House Is Not a Home. And Richard's in that. I'm the star of the film. Richard plays a very big supporting character in the film. It's the first horror film with a majority African-American cast that isn't a comedy. That's a straight scary horror film. And we're actually premiering at the Burbank International Film Festival on September 7th.
So, man, I know you're an enthusiast of art, correct?
Of course.
So is that inspiration to you?
Oh, I mean, I take inspiration from everything. I mean, like, I can walk down the street and see people and take inspiration from that. I mean, Richard's pieces have so much just depth, and some of them are almost like chaos with a message. So you can kind of just stand and look at his pictures and just kind of, it sparks emotion in you. And that's what all art's about, whether it's film, you know, a piece of art, a sculpture, whatever, is for you to look at it and have some sort of a visceral, emotional response to it.
Right.
Hey, this is Gerald Webb from A House Is Not a Home with Richard Grieco. Make sure you check out Fat Ink Magazine. It's hot, y'all. It's hot.
We got Mark Kearney that just arrived on the red carpet. So what do you think about the paintings of, you know, your good friend Richard?
I did a little tour a couple days ago, and I have to say I'm really touched. It's absolutely beautiful art. It's very mindful and heartfelt, and just makes you just sit and take a look at, like, life.
Life differently, right?
Yeah.
Inspiration, correct?
Yeah, I have one of my favorites in there.
So for all the fans and followers that maybe want to get in touch with you, maybe want to see some of your, you know, cooking tips, is there a way?
Well, you can watch us on our new show that's coming out.
Okay. How you doing?
It's going to be a pretty fun lifestyle, crazy, wacky show filmed in the Bahamas.
Wow.
One of my new signature restaurants is coming out of there at the Balmaha Resort in Cable Beach, Bahamas. And we do restaurants like, I don't know, like pies, you know, like my grandmother.
I know you told me that you're like a little bit active, right?
I did a little bit.
Tell me, how was that? How was that life? And why did you choose to stick with the chef?
Well, you know, as a supermodel, I became famous instantly. I'm doing Versace with Turlington and Crawford, and I'm doing all these campaigns. And then, of course, what do you want to do? You want to be an actor, because it comes naturally. And here, food kind of lifted me off. The Spellings and Spielbergs actually hired me to do some really great things, and I just felt that, you know, after callback with producers or getting a movie here or there, you know, somebody wanted to hire me for something I was really good at, and all of a sudden I realized, you know, I wasn't going on auditions anymore. I was cooking.
So that was
from auditions to cooking, that's pretty good.
Well, yeah, you know, I'm very, you know, congratulate you on that.
No, thanks.
Very, very.
Thanks.
I can't see myself cooking. I'd rather watch you cook.
Well, you got to come in my kitchen. I'll teach you.
We'll have to work that out, correct?
Yeah, definitely. Fat ink.
What's inspired you and what got you into painting?
I've been painting for 23 years, so there's nothing that just got me into it. I looked at painting in this day and age in the context of it's 180 degrees and it's kind of literal. I came up with a concept and through a process, through a lot of years, by the way, with de Kooning, Kandinsky, Pollock, Klimt, Picasso, Dali, Francis Bacon, and coming up with a thing that's abstract emotionalism. So no one ever come up with that. So I wanted to combine everything and come up with one thing. And everyone was scared of doing that before, which I didn't really know why. You know, because it's all about emotion. It's all about pure emotion. And if you paint from a purity, like if I said right now, I'm gonna kick the shit out of you, that's pure.
Yes, that's serious. That's very serious.
No, seriously, I'm gonna kick the shit out of you.
Good actor, yeah. And then just keep it like that. Keep the tone.
No, I'm serious. I'm making the show. So if you pay for that perspective, it's about purity. You know what I mean?
Yeah. How do you feel being a culture icon? How do you feel?
Well, I'm only 44, so being a culture icon, I feel kind of young to be an icon.
Because there's a lot of people out there that I've been asking, all your friends, a lot of actors, actresses.
Well, I started a fashion thing. You know, with the ripped jeans, the headband, the leather jacket, stuff like that. But that was me when I was 14. I came out to L.A. and auditioned like that. I was not acting.
You're just being yourself, right?
I was being myself. But when I was back in high school, they looked at me like a friggin' loser, like leather jacket with a headband and ripped jeans, you know. Hi, I'm Richard Grieco, and you're watching Fat Ink.
This is Celebrity Blue, Fat Ink Magazine, here at the red carpet. Great paintings, something to watch. Stay tuned, stay updated, stay fat. Once again, fatinkmag.com, Celebrity Blue. Peace.